properties of inequalities of sides and angles of a triangle. You can see an activity here. As shown in the figure, draw triangle XYZ such that XZ is greater than side XY. Find which of angle Z and angle Y is greater. You can do this. Draw this figure XYZ in such a way that XZ is greater than XY, and manually you can find out which of angle Z and angle Y is greater by using a protractor. Now, come to the properties of inequalities of sides and angles of a triangle. There is a theorem. If two sides of a triangle are unequal, then the angle opposite to the greater side is greater than angle opposite to the smaller side. If two sides of a triangle are unequal, so what is given in triangle XYZ? You are considering figure 3.45. In triangle XYZ, we have taken side XZ to be greater than side XY. Then we have to prove the angle opposite to the greater side is greater than angle opposite to the smaller side. That is, which is the angle opposite to the greater side now? We have taken the greater side to be XZ. So the angle opposite to XZ will be XYZ. So we have to prove angle XYZ is greater than angle opposite to the smaller side. What is the angle opposite to the smaller side? We have taken the smaller side to be XY. So angle opposite to it will be angle XZY. So we have to prove angle XYZ is greater than angle XZY. Now, keeping this figure as it is, we cannot do anything. So we'll try to make a construction. We'll take point P on side XZ such that the side XZ is the greater side. So on the greater side, we are taking the point P such that XY will be equal to XP. That means length of XY will be equal to length of XP. So there are equal markings over here. You can see in figure 3.45. Now, coming to the proof. We have to prove angle XYZ is greater than angle XZY. Now, take triangle XYP. It is an isosceles triangle. Because XY is equal to XP according to the construction. Two sides are equal in a triangle, so the triangle becomes an isosceles triangle. And by the isosceles triangle theorem, we know that the opposite sides also will be congruent. If two sides are congruent in a triangle, then the opposite angles will be congruent. So here, what is the opposite angle to side XY? Angle XPY. And what is the opposite angle to side XP? It is angle XYP. So we get angle XYP is equal to angle XPY. You have to write the reason. Isosceles triangle theorem. We are taking this equation to be the first equation. Now, you can see triangle YPZ in the figure. In triangle YPZ, one of the sides is extended, that is side PZ is extended, and you get an exterior angle there. Angle XPY is an exterior angle of triangle YPZ. So, you can use the exterior angle theorem. The exterior angle is always greater than one of the remote interior angles. So, in triangle YPZ, we have two remote interior angles because PYZ and PZY are remote interior angles. Because we are considering the exterior angle, angle XPY. When you consider that, YPZ is an interior angle and PYZ and PZY becomes the remote interior angles. We have to select any one, so let us select PZY for our convenience. So one of the remote interior angles is angle PZY. According to the exterior angle theorem, the exterior angle is always greater than one of the remote interior angles. So angle XPY is greater than angle PZY by exterior angle theorem. We have taken angle XPY to be the exterior angle and angle PZY is one of the remote interior angles. According to the exterior angle theorem, angle XPY is always greater than one of the remote interior angles. So angle XPY is greater than angle PZY. Now, look at angle XPY. This angle is equal to angle XYP because of equation number 1. So now, instead of angle XPY, we can replace by angle XYP because of equation number 1. Because in equation number 1, angle XPY is equal to angle XYP. So you can replace this angle XPY by angle XYP. So you get the equation, angle XYP is greater than angle PZY. Within brackets, you write the reason from equation 1. Now, you know the algebraic equality like this. If A is greater than B and C is greater than 0, then C is greater than 0 means C is a positive number. It is strictly greater than 0. C is not equal to 0. C is strictly greater than 0. That means C is a positive real number. If A is greater than B and C is a positive number, then we can add one C on the A is greater than B is the inequality given. And C we have taken to be a positive number. That is non-negative real number. Then, if you add C on the left hand side of this inequality A greater than B, then you will get for sure A plus C also will be strictly greater than B. Because A is strictly greater than B, A plus C is also strictly greater than B because C is a positive number, that is a non-negative real number. So the value on the left hand side is always becoming bigger than B. So if A is greater than B, then A plus C also will be greater than B. We are applying that sense over here. So you are taking angle XYP to be A, then greater than angle PZY to be B and angle PYZ to be C. So apply it over here. If A is strictly greater than B and C is a non-negative real number, then A plus C is strictly greater than B. So instead of A, I asked you to put angle XYP. And instead of B, I asked you to put angle PZY. And instead of C, I asked you to put angle PYZ. then how the equation becomes angle XYP plus angle PYZ is greater than angle PZY, because A plus C is greater than B. We have taken A to be angle XYP, we have taken B to be angle PZY, and we have taken C to be angle PYZ. So we get the inequality angle XYP plus angle PYZ is strictly greater than angle PZY. Now we want to prove angle XYZ is greater than angle XZY. Now here, look at angle XYP plus angle PYZ in the figure. Angle XYP plus angle PYZ, if you add it together by the angle addition property, it will become angle XYZ. So by angle addition property, we get angle XYP plus angle PYZ to be angle XYZ. So angle XYZ is greater than angle PZY. What is PZY? It is otherwise angle XZY, because P is lying between X and Z. So we can write angle PZY to be angle XZY. So we get angle XYZ is greater than angle XZY. Now coming to the next theorem. If two angles of a triangle are unequal, then the side opposite to the greater angle is greater than the side opposite to smaller angle. The theorem can be proved by indirect proof. Complete the following proof by filling in the blanks. You are given triangle ABC. Angle B is greater than angle C. You can see figure 3.46. Angle B is greater than angle C in the figure. We have to prove, what is the side opposite to angle B? AC. What is the side opposite to angle C? AB. So we have to prove that the side opposite to greater angle is greater than the side opposite to smaller angle. So we have to prove AC is greater than AB. Coming to the proof, there are only three possibilities regarding the lengths of side AB and side AC of triangle ABC. So we are doing by indirect proof method. So we want to prove AC is greater than AB, and there are only three possibilities regarding the lengths of side AB and side AC of triangle ABC. The first possibility is AC is less than AB. Second possibility is AC is equal to AB. If both these possibilities are wrong, then the next possibility is AC is greater than AB. So we have to prove that AC is less than AB, the first possibility, and the second possibility AC is equal to AB to be wrong, then only the third possibility AC is greater than AB will be true. So now in the box you will get the second possibility is AC is equal to AB. And the third possibility is AC is greater than AB. Now, us assume that AC is less than AB. Now, for indirect proof, first we'll assume a wrong statement, then we'll come across a contradiction, then our assumption will be wrong, and we'll be proving what we have to prove. Now, so we are assuming means supposing. Let us suppose AC is less than AB. We have to prove AC is greater than AB. So we have to assume the other possibilities first. So let us assume AC is less than, first possibility is AC is less than AB. Second possibility we have taken as AC is equal to AB. If these both are wrong, then only the third one will be true. So let us suppose that, otherwise let us assume that AC is less than AB. If two sides of a triangle are unequal, then the angle opposite to greater side is greater. As just now we had learned. So here you have to write greater. Now, therefore, angle C will be greater than which angle? AC is less than AB, we have taken. So, opposite side AC, we have angle B. Opposite side AB, we have angle C. So, angle B will be less than angle C. So, how to read from the other side? Angle C will be greater than angle B. So, angle C is greater than angle B. Now, what is given? Angle B is greater than angle C. So, read from the other side, you'll get angle C is greater than, so less than angle B. So, here, angle C is less than angle B is given. Now, this creates a contradiction because in the previous step we are having angle C is greater than angle B. The same angle C, how it will be less than angle B. So, it creates a contradiction. That means it creates an opposite idea. So, our assumption is wrong. What we assumed? We assumed AC is less than AB. So, our assumption is wrong. So, AC less than AB is wrong. So, now out of these three possibilities, the first one, AC is less than AB is wrong, we have proved. Now, come to the second one. AC is equal to AB. If AC is equal to AB, then opposite to AC, we have the angle B. Opposite to AB, we have angle C. Look at the figure. Then, angle B is equal to angle C. If two sides of a triangle are equal, then the triangle becomes an isosceles triangle. So, we can apply the isosceles triangle theorem here and write the opposite angles to those sides are congruent. So, angle B is equal to angle C. But what is given? We are given angle B is greater than angle C. We are given angle B is greater than angle C. So, this also creates a contradiction. In the previous step, you are having angle B is equal to angle C. In the next step, you are having angle B is greater than angle C. So, this also creates an opposite idea. This also creates a contradiction. So, our assumption is wrong. What is the assumption? AC is equal to AB was our assumption. So, that assumption also becomes wrong. What is the remaining possibility? AC is greater than AB. Since both these possibilities became wrong, automatically you will get the third one to be true. So, therefore, AC is greater than AB, that is AC is strictly greater than AB, is the only remaining possibility. Therefore, AC is greater than AB. Now, let's recall. As shown in the adjacent picture, there is a shop at A. Samir was standing at C. To reach the shop, he chose the way C goes to A, from C to A, instead of C to B and B to A, because he knew that the way C to A was shorter than the way C to B, then B to A. So which property of a triangle had he realized? The sum of two sides of a triangle is greater than its third side. The sum of two sides of a triangle is always greater than its third side. Now let us prove this property. The sum of any two sides of a triangle is greater than the third side. So we have taken a triangle ABC. We have to prove AB plus AC is greater than BC. Greater means strictly greater than. AB plus AC is strictly greater than BC. AB plus BC is greater than AC. Strictly greater than AC. AC plus BC is also strictly greater than AB. So, we have to prove all these three inequalities. It is enough to prove any one of these inequalities. Then we can say similarly we can prove the other two inequalities. So, for this you are doing a construction. You are taking a point D on ray BA. Extend the side AB. And you get in this direction. So, you get on ray BA. You take a point D such that AD is equal to AC. Now, in triangle ACD, AC is equal to AD because of a construction. Therefore, opposite angles are congruent. The reason is not corresponding angles are congruent triangles. This is a wrong reason. Please cut it in your textbook. Angles opposite to congruent sides will be the correct reason here. Otherwise, you can write by isosceles triangle theorem. So, you can write here angles opposite to congruent sides. Otherwise, you can write by isosceles triangle theorem. By isosceles triangle theorem. Now, if you add some angle measure over here, angle ACD is on the left hand side and angle ADC is on the right hand side and we are having an equal to sign. So, if I am considering one measure of third measure, and see, suppose we are considering this is angle A and this one is angle B. Angle A is equal to angle B. So, angle A is equal to angle B. If I take one angle C, that is angle ACB to be angle C. If angle A is greater than angle B and angle ACB is strictly greater than 0, that is angle C I have taken. So, if angle A is equal to angle B, in this step, angle ACD is equal to angle ADC. I have taken angle ACD to be A and angle ADC to be B. So A is equal to B. If A is equal to B, then A plus C will be surely greater than B. If A is equal to B and C is greater than 0, strictly greater than 0, then A plus C will be equal, strictly greater than B. So we get this statement. A is equal to B here. So A plus, I have added one angle here, measure of angle here on the left hand side. So value of left hand side increases. It will not be surely equal to the right hand side's value. So now it will be strictly greater than angle ADC. Now look at this in the figure. Angle ACD plus angle ACB. Angle ACD plus angle ACB. When you combine this by angle addition property, you will get it to be angle BCD. So you can write angle BCD is greater than angle ADC. Now look at the triangle once again. So look at angle BCD and angle ADC in figure 3.47. Angle BCD is this full angle. So the side opposite it will be side BD. Angle ADC is this angle. And the side opposite to this angle will be side BC. If you take the entire triangle DBC. So you get side BD is greater than side BC. Side opposite to greater angle is greater. It is the reason. Therefore, now BD, look at BD. It can be written as, split up as BA plus AD. Because of the betweenness property, A is between B and D. So BA plus AD is greater than BC. Since BD is split up as BA plus AD, BD can be written as BA plus AD. Now, coming to the next step, we know AD is equal to AC because of a construction. So we can replace this AD by AC. So we'll get BA plus AC is strictly greater than BC. Similarly, we can prove the other two. We have proved the first one, AB plus AC is greater than BC. Similarly, we can prove the other two inequalities. That is, AB plus BC is greater than AC and AC plus BC is greater than AB. Hence, we prove that the sum of any two sides of a triangle is greater than the third side.